What is up, guys? It is me, your host, Joe. I know, sorry. Anyways, it is like 2:30 in the morning here. I would do a live stream, but I doubt anyone would watch it. And I have a bad case of insomnia, so figured why not record a video and then have it upload for you guys to watch tomorrow. Anyways, I fast forward time about 2 days. You can see that our swaths are a little bit reduced. That is just one of the features of Seasons Mod. This not as much, a little reduced. I rank these about a day after that other field. But you can still see there's pretty significant reduction. Now if we run over to our bales over here, I think these are actually starting to, yeah, we lost about 240 liters in those bales, so we're gonna have to get those chewed up or stored in a shed where there's no snow mass. So this not really sure where I'm gonna store these bales, to be honest. I might move some of my tillage equipment outside and put the planter in here, and I could use this lower shop for hay bale storage for now. So I think that's gonna be my designated bale shed. Or yeah, that's not big enough. Maybe I'll change this barn out to be like a bale shed with no walls, you know? Just a steel roof. I think that'd probably be the better option. Anyways, I believe we have some room in our silos for, yeah, this one's not even on. So what we're gonna do is, I'm gonna do a little bit of chopping for you guys. This tractor's all washed up, fueled up, ready to go. I'm debating on whether if I should model a new chopper or a new Frontier Merger. What I really need is it's a new planter, but for corn and stuff. I mean, we could just plant beans for all I care. Got a good Great Plains planter now, and just use a draper header. In real life, like, we don't grow enough crops here. I mean, if we were to plant corn, it would be strictly for chopping for silage, I'm sure. Or to grind up into some kind of feed. Give this a go. This tractor is a little underpowered. See the black smoke just pouring out of this thing. This chopper is rated at like 120 or 150 horsepower or whatever it is. And I don't even think this tractor is even over 200 horse, so. It's definitely a workout for this guy. Well, I think he'll do just fine. So we're gonna fill up our silos again. And then whatever we have left over, I guess we'll bail. I'm actually kind of glad the windrows got a little reduced. I thought we were going to have more than we can actually handle, you know. I don't have any bale cell points on this map yet. It's not like we could sell our access hay bale, although I think I might put a trigger down by like the dealer, the animal where you buy and sell your animals, and maybe put some grass and like bale cell triggers at some of these other like hobby farms, you know, the random beef hobby farm and some horse hobby farms. So. You could always sell your excess hay. That's pretty common. A lot of these guys, you know, all the horse people that own horses, they don't farm, they don't have land. You know, they're always buying the hay and straw from other people, so. Make perfect sense. So the nice thing about not doing a live stream is I think I can get a higher quality video, but that's to be seen, I guess. Don't even have enough power to turn this rig around. Are about 80%. I'm gonna need to grab another wagon. This is going a lot smoother than the other time I was chopping this. So. That means we're full. this other trailer over. We only have two of these chopper wagons. If it was on multiplayer or if I had my chopper on course play, it'd be a little different, but I think two's fine since it is just me. And it seems like we can go a decent ways. Did like 1.5, maybe less than 1.5 times around that field for a full wagon. That's not a small field either. But these things hold roughly 34,000 liters. I waited a long time to be able to do this. The last time I used a pole type chopper was back in 13, and I was using semi trailers. I was using like a 8RT tractor or something like that. And I had semi trucks hooked up. When they were using course play, they were driving to like the biogas plant. I should find that video and post a link, because I'm sure most people haven't seen it. Actually, it's probably a really highly viewed video, so maybe a lot of people have watched it, but it's been a while. It's probably been 3-4 years. But that was like when the MR more realistic was out, and that's what brought me back into Farm Sim was that. I haven't messed around with it in 17 yet, because as you can see, I mean, the physics and stuff isn't that great, but you can see that tractor struggling with that chopper, so they've improved the in-game physics to the point where the game is actually playable without the MR engine, where 13 was, you know, unbearable. Like, there's no way I could have. So before I dump it here, okay, so that's about half empty. We'll be able to get a wagon. And this one. You know, I'm not quite sure what the purpose is of these augers. I'm assuming it's to, like, feed. I don't know. Feed stuff toward the conveyor, but it just doesn't seem like it would function. I mean, I see things around the floor, so maybe it's to. So stuff coming out the side, it pushes it down. I'm not 100% positive. So appears to be day 9. It's late spring. Looks like we got 4 more days until summer comes around, so I'd like to get this hay off. I feel like every time I log on to this, I save and log back on, the weather changes. You know, like, in the forecast, it's supposed to be 2 days till it rained, and then I come back on and it's different. Anyways, back to chopping. Downside with these wagons is if you don't help the driver out, so apparently we've chopped 4.7 hectares with this thing so far. Pretty decent distance, since this thing's only like probably 3 meters wide. So hopefully those of you that are really into the big crop farming operation aren't too disappointed. I'm a little sick of it, because I feel like that's all I've been doing for the last, you know, 2 years in this game. I mean, the whole time I was playing on Wind Chaser, it was always crop farm, like big equipment. And so this is kind of nice to use some of the smaller stuff, smaller pace, where we're, you know, I have 76 grand in the bank right now, but I also have like over $100,000 loan that I still need to pay off. So we're struggling. We have about 60 some odd cows, so they're producing milk. So we'll do fine. We have quite a bit of land. I mean, one thing I do miss was the land tax, where you had to pay tax on the land that you owe. That was really cool. Pay property tax. And income tax and everything like that. I think that would be a really tie in really well with seasons, like come April or whatever your fiscal year is for your business. You gotta come up with a big rent check. So typically I wouldn't be chopping hay, but I was indecisive. I wasn't sure if I was gonna bale this or chop it. We just happened to be chopping this. Which is fine. Our silo could use some more silage. It's only about, both of them are about 50% full. So we need to put about 150,000 liters of silage in between the two. Should have 300,000 liters of total silage, which we can feed our cows. Yeah, this really is a nice field to chop. I think I might always chop this one in 28 because they're so straight and long and flat, The other two fields, and then that third hay field we picked up, 41. Those aren't good haylage fields at all. This one is just about full. So we'll run down to our wagon. So this little guy, he's only 175 horse. I think he's a kind of the same horsepower as this other 4755 here. It's got to be close. Take this guy and dump this one into our little silo. Give that guy something to chew on. guys unloading, get back to chopping. After we're done chopping this field, we'll probably roll it, get some good fertilizer into it, flatten it out. You know, watching videos of these pole type chopping operations is probably my favorite video to watch. Just the sound, all the activity guys running around. Like, I mean, the self-propelled choppers, those are great too, but there's just something really satisfying about watching a nice pole chopper. Usually those big New Hollands with the dual wheels on them. Watching these carts unload into the... You know, everyone's using bags, silage bags. I'm not a farmer, so I'm not really sure. In my area, I always thought that they put them in those blue Harvestone silos. Maybe those things have too many issues, or it's not cost effective. The bags are a cheaper, quicker, more reliable way to ferment your haylage. But can't go wrong with the plastic tarp. So we're coming up on, we might be able to get this whole field in this wagon. It's gonna be close. Well, worst case scenario, we gotta... small wagon out of it. Anyway, Anyways, guys, I've seen, I mean, I know I took a long time off making videos, but, you know, this past, like, 2 weeks or so that I've been recording, I've seen a huge increase in, comments and, increase in subscriptions and stuff like that. So that's always encouraging to see. Glad to see so many people are still enjoying these videos, and new faces are as well. I mean, even if no one really watched them, or if I didn't have as many subscribers, like, I'd still be making videos just because it's, I don't know, like, when I started making videos, no one was really making farm sim videos. It was like, no one was really doing it, to be honest. I mean, I still think back in 2013 when I was doing it, YouTube was still pretty new. There is no one, there's no such thing as like live stream. But I think live streaming in general has kind of caught on across every game. Like, there's just something, like, I myself too, like, I enjoy watching a lot of people play video games. It's the weirdest thing. Like, when you first start thinking about it, it sounds like really like a bizarre thing. Like, just watch someone else play a video game, right? But, it's actually fun to watch. And, I mean, the only downside with making videos and, like, myself being a modder, like, there's a lot of people that make videos that have no clue what they're doing when it comes to modding. And, you know, they have a lot of subscribers and stuff because they're entertaining. But me, I like to use my own things that I make, and then, the only downside of that is people obviously like what they see and they want it and they ask. But I mean, there's nothing wrong with having private mods, and there's nothing wrong with denying people, you know, the instant gratification of getting what they want. You know, it's like in all things in life, you want stuff, you want to be unique, you know? You don't want to, like, go down the block and see everyone that has the same house as you do, or pull up to a parking lot and everyone has the same, you know, make, model, and color of your car. You know, it's there's nothing wrong with wanting to be having, you know, be unique and to stand out. And honestly, like, I've released, you know, quite a few mods over the years, and I mean, I guess there's some level of enjoyment. You see people using your work, but at the same time, it gets so annoying seeing everyone post pictures of the same mod over and over again. So it's refreshing to be original and unique, and again, there's nothing wrong with that. Like, I encourage it. So there's always going to be people that disagree with me on that or don't like that. Can't blame them. I mean, it's human nature. Like, you see cool stuff, you're obviously gonna want it. I think that's just natural instinct. But, you know, I'm no different than any other YouTube channel. I'm just posting videos for entertainment. Just because I happen to mod and have some private mods doesn't mean I'm obligated to share anything. Just like other YouTubers aren't obligated to share their mods, even though probably 95% of them are edits of some, you know, publicly available work. But they're not obligated to share any kind of slight edits or whatever they do. So it doesn't bother me one bit to record videos at work. Doesn't bother me one bit. That's honestly the whole point of this whole entire game. The way it's designed is to give you, the player, the ability to either play the game the way it was originally packaged, you know, no mods, no edits, you just use what's readily available, or you can totally take advantage how every aspect of this game pretty much can be personalized and modified. You know, that's the whole sandbox part of this game, and they give you the tools to do it. They give you modding tutorials. They give you an engine to do editing. They support Blender and Maya importing and exporting. So the game is addictive because it is so open. And like this map is literally 90, I would say 95% accurate to the elevation in the satellite imaging of Osceola, city of Osceola and surrounding areas. So you can literally model up whatever your heart desires and in-game it and use it in this game. Anyway, it's figured about 7,000 liters of halogen in this wagon. Question is, I need to figure out how much room is in that those silos still. Because we're probably only getting, like, out of these two fields, we might get like 16 or less bales. It's hard to say. Last time I baled those two fields, it was like right around 16 bales, but that was with full swaths. So this was reduced quite a bit, so might get like 10 bales out of the 80,000 liters or so. Maybe more. So this big silo is full, so we can't put anything more in there anyways. We can just sneak a little bit more in this one. Anymore. So I think we're done chopping. Because both of our silos are full again. Yeah, that's damn close. pull this whole rig over here for now. And then we're gonna bail the rest of this stuff. So I actually wash this baler. Decent heap. Yeah, it doesn't show us the fill level like it used to. Anyways, I'm just gonna take my baler here and bale up this grass. Massive amount. That's good for now. So I rake these already. I'm curious what our animals are doing. Fertilization 3 states. Animals productivity 90%. So that's gonna bump up. We just kind of clean this whole thing up. We're at 60 cows own. Doesn't tell me what my reproduction rate is, but we're definitely good on any kind of food. I actually fudged these numbers when I first started this game. Nice thing is you can put like 90% of your chamber's grass and put a little bit of hay. So the amount of hay in these swaths reduced quite a bit. I'm surprised. I only let it sit out here for about 2 days. Like I sped through 2 days time. Surprisingly the amount of reduction that happens is significant. Those swaths over there look a lot bigger. Which is interesting because I baled or I raked these at the same time. two small hay fields that we're gonna keep baling, mowing, you know, mailing and working for hopefully three more times this year. I suggested to the mod authors of Seasons Mod to have a certain percentage of winter kill on the hay, because honestly, I think it's time to have grass that gets killed off. Because you have to plant, you know, harvest and plant every other crop. But when it comes to hay, it's 100% perfect. You know, it's your best crop, really. Tonnage is so low in this field. Man. Once you rake your hay, you better bale it or chop it. These swaths are a little bit more productive. They appear to be. I was tempted to put the Great Plains seed drill on the what is it, the 89, I forget what we own. It's either 8960 or 70. Tractor. I was kind of guessing we're going to get 10 bales between these two fields, so I think we're on track to do even less than that. I think this field last time I baled it, I got at least 8. If not more. I'm going to go back and watch that video. I think all the bales behind the shed came from this field. bad day for the Lindell farm. Every time I play, I'm trying to record, so there's sometimes when I hop on a plane, I'm not recording, and I feel like it's kind of a lost opportunity. But, I mean, it's nice to, if I'm not recording, I don't have to wear my headphones, I can listen to a movie, like I can do so many other things then. Here when I'm live streaming or making a video, I have to focus on this so it's somewhat decent. It is different not live streaming. I kinda am so used to doing the live streams lately. You know, I can't remember the last time I recorded a video and it wasn't a live stream. It's kinda different. I used to only do this and I rarely live streamed, but having that real time commentary and feedback is a lot better than this. That's nice with the live stream. Like, I can't keep up with all the comments or answer all the questions. I would say 80% of the questions being asked in every live stream are asked in every live stream, asked and re-asked, so it's nice to rely on those in the comments to help answer. Appears to be yielding a lot better. Get over and check the beans while I'm here. Beans look good, no disease, no weeds. Perfect beans. Swath right there. Went from 50 to 58 in like no time. If I let a bailout here, it'll roll downhill maybe, but that's fine. Yeah, the guy's gone. Pick him up later. Should have backed it up, but lazy. We already have four bales out of this field, and we're not even halfway done, so this looks promising. our ninth bale out of this section. So it looks like the total is going to be right around the 13 mark. So that's pretty good. I was guesstimating right around the 10 or so. The rake is still leaving a little patch when it's on one side, so I'm gonna have to kind of, I think it's dropping off outside the pickup of the next node down, so I'm gonna have to fool around with that a little bit. It's only on the one side, so. So 13 new bales. Too shabby. The rest of this. So that's all she wrote for hay, and then let's see here. Nice, our productivity's up 100%. 3,100 liters of milk. Vehicle running cost, animal upkeep. Let's see if we can. Yeah, we had 125,000 loan. I'm not really sure what the whole maintenance thing is. I don't know, that might take care of itself, or I'm not 100% sure how that all, how that all works out, to be honest. I'm not sure if you have to bring stuff to the dealer or not, but it's a nice picture. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching.